Now that my husband is no longer commander-in-chief, they tell me I have to leave the White House. Okay. Do I still have the corona? I don't know. Let's see if America can run on Duncan. Mr. Joe Biden's wife is a doctor. Okay. Sweet dreams, Dr. Beach.
Hello, everybody. Just another day that the Lord has made, boy. Blessings for everybody. You see that intro? Ain't that how it is? So much is going on. Trump, who do you think you are? Before I begin any of my ranting and raving that I do oh so well, let me show you what I'm working with. Basic. Getting ready for Thanksgiving, not trying to overcook. Spaghetti meatballs. Look at that. Look at that. I baked the meatballs today. Didn't really feel like a lot. Got my salad. Turkey bacon bits. Croutons, lettuce, cabbage. Drinking Arizona sweet tea today, boys and girls. Love Arizona. Using Italian. Let's go ahead and say our grace. Jump right in. Dear Heavenly Father, thank you for this food that we're about to receive. May it nourish our bodies and strengthen our minds. In your name we both pray. Amen. Amen. Trump, respect my authority. You don't know nothing about that. Trying this new Parmesan. I'm interested. Looks good. Don't mean nothing, though. Let's start off by saying this. Donald Trump is still playing hide-and-go-seek. Still refusing to run the country. Because he didn't win. Such a sore loser.
President Trump is missing in action. He seems to have quit on the American people. It's an extraordinary thing to witness.
Still, they are getting on people about wearing their masks and people not wearing their masks.
Don't stay away for too long.
I know we in the middle of a pandemic right now. Y'all know y'all supposed to wear y'all damn mask. He got all over Democrat Sherrod Brown because she asked the Republican senator to wear his mask on the floor. He tweeted, he playing the Trump, called her a complete ass. Are you serious?
Senator Cruz called his Democratic colleague Sherrod Brown a, quote, complete ass on Twitter for asking Republican Senator Dan Sullivan of Alaska to wear a mask on the Senate floor.
You can't have the coronavirus like you can't have the common cold. You can't have a cough, you can't have a sneeze. But people try it every day, for they won't be pointed at. You got the coronavirus. People better get over themselves. I give y'all the first bite. And how you gonna say that she's a complete ass when Iowa Senator Grassley, 87, just tested positive for the coronavirus. And he was on the same floor the Democrat Sherrod Brown was on when she asked him to wear the mask.
This partisan kerfuffle over mask use in the windowless Senate chamber is taking on a new meaning now that Iowa Senator Chuck Grassley, who was on the floor around the same time, announced on Twitter that he has tested positive for coronavirus. Grassley is 87, and that puts him in a vulnerable category. Mm-hmm. He spoke for minutes about the president's Federal Reserve Board nominee while not wearing a mask. He tweeted later, "Feeling good and will keep up my work for the people of Iowa from home. I appreciate everyone's well wishes and prayers and look forward to resuming my normal schedule soon."
You put my life in jeopardy, I'm suing you.
Thank God the senator from Iowa is feeling good, but his infection is raising new questions about the safety in the Senate, and not just for the safety of the senators. On Monday, Alaska Republican Dan Sullivan, as we mentioned, was presiding over the chamber, and that is when Sherrod Brown opened his remarks by asking Sullivan to put on his mask.
I bet Trump's ass wish he never ran for president. When you ran for president, baby, let me explain. You left yourself wide open. You told on yourself. You know you crooked. You was crooked before you even ran for president. Been cheating people out of money and business deals and schemes for years. Now they're coming for you, baby. And that's why you flipping out. They talking about he's having a meltdown. He know when he come out, he going in. You doing just like them idiot rappers. One to do crimes and then rap about it.
Bro, look how much money we got.
This one for all my shooters.
Bro, what you doing in there?
All my killers out there. We came from eating ramen noodles and now we killing poodles.
Bro, is this recording
y'all
song?
Crazy, man. Yeah. Just robbed the bank and took a trip to GameStop. Stole a PS5, a couple games, and ran from the cops with my nigga Greg Simmons. Yeah, we bout to pay the rent. He got all the money, bout to hide it in the fucking vent. 3057 West Central Park Way, Orlando, Florida. Yeah, you know where I stay. I did the crime, but I ain't scared of the cops, cause I got illegal guns. I feel like the Black Ops. Hey.
Yo, that shit was hard? Bro, why would you record a song about the crime we just did?
You done made that up. But I didn't, because they do. You trying to intimidate people, Trump.
Out front tonight, overturning the will of the people. That is what the President of the United States is trying to do. Right in front of our eyes.
Hell no.
Literally, just look.
You trying to intimidate people. You can't intimidate nobody, honey. Your little orange skin and your little hands don't intimidate nobody. You ain't no thug. You ain't from the hood.
Hey, on my mama and on my granny and on my baby mama, I am from the hood.
Bro, you got to be the softest white boy I've ever seen in my entire life, bro. If he was to come to where I stay, you wouldn't have nothing that around your neck, your teeth, none of that, bro. They done took that from you. Made you walk home naked. For real.
Even Pennywise don't go to the hood.
Run.
It's pretty good. Check this out. Yeah. Oh, look at that. Did you know that Trump had 7 Michigan lawmakers come to the White House trying to intimidate them men to give him the electoral vote?
Watch your own eyes. That's a meeting today. 7 Republican lawmakers from Michigan. The president invited them to the White House, including the leader of the state Senate and the speaker of the state House. Why did he invite them, bring them, fly them to Washington? Well, in a far-fetched and legally dubious strategy, Trump wants Republican legislature in Michigan to step in and name electors supporting him to the Electoral College. So to give those electoral votes of Michigan to him instead of to Joe Biden. That's the will of the Michigan voters, right? They chose Joe Biden by a margin of 154,000 votes. But we are learning just now that the Michigan Republicans at that meeting did not cave to Trump. Tonight, they're doing what is right. They have put out a statement that reads in part, quote, "We have not yet been made aware of any information that would change the outcome of the election in Michigan. And as legislative leaders, we will follow the law and follow the normal process regarding Michigan's electors." And then the Michigan Republican leaders continue with a clear message for Trump, quote, "Michigan's certification process should be a deliberate process free from threats and intimidation. And the candidates who win the most votes win elections and Michigan's electoral votes. These are simple truths."
He's trying to overturn the vote of the people. No, you can't do that. He's trying everything he can. And the reason why he's fighting so hard, because he's about to go to prison for all the fraud and everything else he's done. One thing that I will say, Biden finally met with Posey's old crooked ass, Nancy Pelosi, to try to get some pandemic relief.
President-elect Joe Biden met with Senate Minority Leader Chuck Schumer and House Speaker Nancy Pelosi on Friday, atop the agenda, finally passing a long-stalled coronavirus relief package in a lame duck session. As America enters the holiday season, upwards of 54 million people are facing food insecurity, and more than half of the 20 million Americans now receiving some form of unemployment benefits will lose that assistance when those federal pandemic programs expire at the end of the year. In about a month, these key initiatives are scheduled to end. Expanded unemployment benefits, student loan payment pause, eviction protection, paid family leave, coronavirus relief funds for states.
He's president-elect. He should have some form of powers. This is crazy. Democrat Congressman Hakeem Jeffries, he said they're going to stay in Washington as long as they have to. To make sure it happens. To make sure people have pandemic relief.
Relief package is on the way and other issues. The chairman of the House Democratic Caucus, New York Congressman Hakeem Jeffries. Congressman, thank you so much for joining me. Let's start with this question of relief on the way. A lot of people are waiting for it. The House Speaker said this week she's optimistic about a new stimulus bill. But as you well know, you need the Senate Majority Leader Mitch McConnell to make that happen. Where does her optimism come from?
Well, she's working incredibly hard, and we're prepared to stay in Washington for as long as necessary to arrive at a coronavirus pandemic relief package, because as you've just described, the situation on the ground requires it. The pain, the suffering, and the death being experienced by the American people, the unemployment, the food insecurity, the housing uncertainty, that's not getting better. It's getting worse. That's why House Democrats acted initially in May with the HEROES Act, and then acted again on October 1st. Now, Mitch McConnell has seemed to publicly send some messages that he's prepared to do something. It's our hope over the next few weeks when we return to Washington in the aftermath of the Thanksgiving recess that they come to the table with genuineness and authenticity, meaning Senate Republicans, committed to finally getting this done.
Melania Trump, a month ago, she said she even cared nothing about Christmas, nothing about the kids. Basically, she said, fuck them kids.
They say I'm complicit. I'm the same like him. I support him. I don't say enough. I don't do enough.
No.
I'm working like my ass.
I know.
The Christmas stuff that, you know, who gives a f*** about Christmas stuff and decoration, but I need to do it, right?
Yeah, but 100%. You have no choice.
And okay, and then I do it, and I say that I'm working on Christmas, planning for the Christmas. And they said, oh, what about the children that they were separated? Give me a break. Where they were saying anything when Obama did that?
I know.
I cannot go. I was trying to get the kid reunited with the mom. I didn't have a chance. It needs to go through the process and through the law.
But here's my thing. Hear what you just said. But instead of that, if you just, your messaging, you were so loved.
They would not do the story. We put it out. They would not do the story.
I'm telling
you. Would not believe it. They would not do the story because they would not do the story because they are against us because they are liberal media. Yeah, if I go to Fox, they will do the story. I don't want to go to Fox.
Basically, Melania Trump is saying, fuck Christmas, fuck them kids. She said everybody coming for them. She said, I'm trying to stand by my husband. I'm trying. This is above your pay grade, Melania. I feel sorry for you, baby. She said that no one will listen to her. And she said that it's a proper channel that you gotta go through. You gotta do the law. Well, if you know that, why don't your husband know that? Intimidation ain't gonna get you nowhere, baby.
Them to come to Washington from Michigan to have this meeting. Tell us what you've learned.
Clearly, it did not go the way the president wanted it to, because while the White House said it wasn't an advocacy meeting, you're seeing this statement that they put out tonight saying that there is no new information changing their mind about who won the state of Michigan. And I think that's incredibly notable, because while the White House was saying that it wasn't political focused, it wasn't politically motivated to have this meeting, you know, we did know that people from the campaign were supposed to be there, including Rudy Giuliani, who did not show up only because his son tested positive for coronavirus. And so the question is really, what's next here, Aaron? Because the president has made all of these last-ditch efforts to try to overturn the results, unparalleled efforts, we should note, by inviting these state legislators to the White House today. And we're told that he has plans to do similar for Pennsylvania, though those invitations don't appear to have been extended yet. But they really appear to have been exhausting all of their options, because initially they said, wait for the votes to come out, then we'll show the president has won. Clearly that did not happen. Then they said, wait for our lawsuits. We now see that the president and his allies have lost or withdrawn over 24 lawsuits, only winning 2 cases so far for a small number of votes. That's not going to change the outcome of this election. And then clearly this pressure campaign that the president had in mind didn't work, because you saw his attorney, Sidney Powell, saying yesterday that the goal of this was to get them to change the electors to be for Donald Trump, which of course would be overriding the votes of people in this state, especially Michigan, where Joe Biden has a margin of 150,000 voters. So the question really is what does the president do next? He did not answer our questions today, so.
Try that intimidation on Brucey and them in the penitentiary. Ain't that it? That's exactly what Bruce gonna say to you. Brucey's time to shine. But it won't be the longest yard, baby, because I know you can't run. You better work on your cardio now. Be like Zombie Land. So we know who the real Mr. and Mrs. Grinch of Christmas is.
Yeah! Walked in the building, now who's looking at me? Santa suit on, and you know my hair nappy. Hey, hey, hey. Okay, okay, okay. Now watch y'all do it to the stands now. Grinch is on that beat.
I don't care how hip y'all trying to make it. What happened to you, Trump? You never was a good guy. But you never was a guy to put all your business out in the open. Now everybody know your dirt. Ain't no tea leaf left unturned in the glass. I need a meditation break.
Oh, Lucifer's estate. I fell in love with a girl I met in hell, thinking about all the
Trump work on my nerves so bad, y'all. Well, if you guys like what you've seen here, like, comment, and subscribe. And I'll talk to you guys soon.